On December 2012, the Mufti of Australia, along with Islamic Relief, made history by sending Australia's largest ever humanitarian convoy of Muslim delegates. 22 prominent sheikhs and community figures departed the shores of Sydney in a bid to aid their fellow Muslims living in the world's most critical conditions.
The official journey began with a highly anticipated trip to the Rafah crossing. A drive over 6 hours long, yet the thought of finally being able to visit the besieged Gaza Strip made it well worth the wait.
الملكة هي غزة. ملكة العز وملكة الكرامة وملكة الحرية ونحن نتعشقها.
From the many trips I've traveled, I've never felt this beautiful feeling that I feel like I'm really contributing to this ummah. We're only a few kilometers away from Gaza and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that the way we enter it this time inshallah, next time inshallah will be an opening inshallah.
It's an amazing feeling. It's my first chance. I hope it's not my last inshallah. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you is to be considered a true believer until he loves for his brother what he loves for himself. So I want a portion of that hadith in my life.
لا شعور حتى الآن لأن القلب منشغل بدعاء الله أن ييسر الدخول. نسأل الله عز وجل بأسماء الحسنى وصفات العلى أن لا يرد هذه القلوب وهذه الوجوه الطيبة إلا بالدخول وعند الدخول سيتغير الشعور ونخبركم به إن شاء الله.
إنها لم تفصل روحنا ولم تفصل مشاعرنا ولم تفصل حبنا لهم وشعورنا بمآسيهم وآلامهم.
For the first time in Australian history was such a large congregation of Australian Muslim delegates to step foot into Gaza. For some, it was a city that they had only heard about on the news, while for others, it was a long-awaited reunion with their childhood home. They didn't waste any time in reminding the delegation why they were here, immediately taking them through an exhibition of carnage and destruction, a painful reminder of what the city had only recently made it out of in the November 8-day war.
آثرت أن تكون الكلمة وأنا أقف لأن غزة يجب أن يقف لها الناس.
The city was still clearly tarnished with remnants from the recent war. Upon arriving at their hotel, they were warmly welcomed by a group of orphans from Gaza.
Children in Gaza, we welcome all of you.
هلا وحيا الله كل الحاضرين والله بيكم.
Their first day of site visits began with an inspection of a former Islamic Relief well, which had recently fallen victim to a deliberate airstrike in the November war.
وقصف تماما ودمروه بشكل كامل وهذا يعني ما بقي من لوحة المشروع اللي كانت موجودة عليه أصلا خلال الفترة الماضية.
They then visited the Umm al-Qura Primary School, which had also been an airstrike target in the recent war. There they met with the children of the destroyed school and heard stories from young ones that they would never forget.
يا أحباءنا الصغار سلاما جعل الله صبحكم يا سمينا يا أحباءنا الصغار سلاما جعل الله صبحكم يا سمينا
السلام عليكم.
وجدت دمار كبير في المدرسة جميع صفوف المدرسة شبابيكها أبوابها الحيطان كلها مهدمة.
الله أكبر.
ما الذي يضير الدنيا من طالب يقرأ ويتعلم؟ ما الذي يضير الدنيا من طالب يذهب إلى مدرسته؟ لماذا تدمر المدارس؟ وهل هؤلاء هم الإرهابيون؟ هذه شهادة شهادة إدانة على كل القوانين الدولية.
بل لم يستم من شرهم حتى الأطفال الأبرياء الذين يتعلمون في المدارس.
فنقول حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل فيهم، ونرسل رسالة للعالم الحر.
أنا بترك وطني مرة.
طب ليه؟ ما أنا حاخدك في مدرسة أحلى وأحسن.
لا أنا بترك وطني.
حتى لو هنعلم التعليم كويس أحسن من اللي هون؟
لا
برضو ما بتتركي؟ أبداً ما بتتركي؟
مهندس.
طب وإيش تتمني تكوني لما تكبري بسني كده؟
مهندسة.
إن شاء الله.
ربنا يحفظك.
ربنا يحفظك.
The sights seen and the stories heard were only to get more emotional as they visited the ministerial building, which had been struck to the ground along with everything in it. The sight of the recent Al-Dalul family massacre proved to be one of the most painful moments in the journey. A multiple-story family home which had been pummeled meters below the ground after an F-16 Israeli airstrike.
اللهم فرج عن أهل هذه البلدة المباركة وأموالهم وأنفسهم وأعراضهم ونسائهم وأوطانهم وشهدائهم.
اللهم يا رب العالمين أنزل على هذه البلدة رحماتك وبركاتك.
في أول فترة قعدنا نص ساعة ندور ما لقيناش حد، بعدها بدأنا ننتشل واحد واحد. كانوا طبعا مشوهين مقطعين يعني أشلاء. 9 نساء وأطفال وشاب واحد.
Hospital visits also ensured the convoy were kept up to date with the extent to what Gaza has experienced.
هذا العدوان استشهد منهم حوالي 186 ومعظم الجرحى والشهداء هم من الأطفال والنساء.
كانت نتيجة لهذه الحرب الشرسة التي استمرت 8 أيام استعمل العدو خلالها كل أنواع الدمار، أصبحت مليئة بالفوسفور الأبيض.
Dar al-Shifa' doctors gave their first-hand accounts of how they treated victims with the most horrific of injuries during all previous wars.
عالج الدلول في نفس الوقت 4 أطفال أصغرهم 9 شهور أكبرهم 7 سنوات وخمس نساء وثلاثة من الرجال، يعني قصفوا البيت على الساكنين كان هنا.
Doctors also expressed their dire circumstances in the hospital as they are left with minimal resources and out-of-date medicine. Over the next few days, in a show of support and appreciation, the convoy visited many Gaza ministers and Islamic leaders, including the local Mufti.
من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، باسم غزة وأهلها جميعا نرحب بضيفنا الكرام.
عن وزارة التربية والتعليم
كل العواصم في كل العواصم العربية والإسلامية.
عام التعليم
The delegation was also invited to witness many of the positive projects and institutions in Gaza, including a prominent Quran teaching college. And an advanced Islamic educational university. The visit was concluded at the Islamic Relief headquarters, where the convoy left a special gift for the people of Gaza.
On behalf of the Australian community, this check to the value of $1 million is presented to Islamic Relief for the people of Gaza.
The journey continued towards the poverty-stricken cities of Egypt. For many of us, this was a surprise and the conditions were highly unexpected, yet severely devastating. Rubbish and pollution had entrenched the cities and many people were struggling to make it through day-to-day life. The convoy visited the clothing manufacturing block, which had been purchased by Islamic Relief to help aid those struggling to make a living while residing in such dire circumstances.
انا رايح اشتغل واكسب، بس ان انا في وضعي
An early intervention and rehabilitation center project by Islamic Relief was also another initiative the convoy had visited, which is now undergoing an expansion project.
Descriptions of كل الاعمال اللي جوه المصانع بحيث ان احنا ناهل ولادنا على الاعمال دي بحيث ان احنا اللي هيقدروا يروحوا من ولادنا للمصانع يشتغلوا هناك واللي مش هيقدروا هيعملوا هنا في الباكينج او في التصنيع بتاعنا.
نقدم هذا الشيك بمليون دولار من مسلمي استراليا لمؤسسة الإسلاميك ريليف.
أنا سعيد جدا إذا ألتقي بأستاذي وشيخي وصديقي سماحة الدكتور علي جمعة مفتي الديار المصرية.
الذي يتعرض له المسلمون في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها بصورة مشوهة.
أنا ابن الأزهر شحماً ولحماً ودماً
وزارة الأوقاف.
It was then time for the highlight, the Syrian border of Jordan. Before being able to make the journey, the delegation was sat down for a debrief of Islamic Relief projects along the border and any background information they needed to know before they could enter. They then collected a few small gifts for distribution and headed out to the Za'atari camp, otherwise known as Mukhaymat al-Mawt, the camps of death due to their inhospitable conditions. Home to over 100,000 refugees who have fled from the world's most dangerous country in the world today, Syria. It was really hard grasping how these children lived here, yet we gave them the little that we had. Young children would melt the hearts of the convoy as they tell their stories and their experiences.
صرنا 20 يوم.
20 يوم.
بس دارنا قصفوها دموها.
دار. هاي.
هاي.
من وين؟
أنا وياه من الشام.
وأنا من درعا.
من درعا ما شاء الله.
كيفك يا حبيبي؟ خد. خد دي ووزعها لإخوانك ها.
Many children had also lost their hearing due to the intense bombardment. This boy's father also lost his hearing as well. Yet he still remained grateful. All his clothes had been stolen during his escape from Syria, and he was left with nothing else apart from the clothes on his body. This was an emotional moment, not only for the Mufti, but for everyone watching. No one knew what to give someone who had lost everything. At this point, the Mufti had broken down completely and had to return to the bus. Not only was it very emotional, but it was very painful. Their goodbyes were given and we continued on for the next camp.
Anwar.
Anwar, من وين?
من درعا.
The conditions here were still extremely poor and barely hospitable. The stories here were just as emotional, and many were extremely fed up with the circumstances.
اكتفينا من التفقد يا زلمة طق عقلنا
شوف الصوت وعلى القدل الموت وعلى القدل الموت وعلى القدل.
The journey ended with a trip to the Jordanian hospital holding a number of Syrian refugees.
بتمنى اكون معهم ازديهم مي ما فيش اكثر بس طشتهم طشتتوا البلاد شتتوا العالم هذا عيز دولها.
A special gift was also left for the people of Syria. Help make a difference today and support this cause to continue helping those in need.